What's up, everyone? Welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new. Today, I am sharing with you guys what is on my lovely Apple Watch. I've had this bad boy for, I want to say, like 3 years now. I can't quite remember how long I've had it, but I wear it literally every single day. I absolutely love my Apple Watch. I'm a big fan, and I thought that I would just share with you what is on it, as well as some Apple Watch hacks that you might not know about. So I just thought this would be a fun little video idea, and maybe will interest some of you. As always, if you're not already, make sure to go follow my social media. I will have them linked down below. And without further ado, let the video commence. So this is my Apple Watch. I have the Apple Watch Series 3 in rose gold. If you couldn't tell by my room, what I'm wearing right now, and my nails, I love pink. Pink is by far my favorite color, and I am obsessed with rose gold. So of course, naturally, I had to have an Apple Watch that coincided with that. So I just have the pink sports band on it as well. I do have another band that I switch out when I am getting dressed up, and it's just another rose gold guy. I got this from Amazon, and it looks exactly the same as the one you would buy from the Apple Store, except it's $10. It is magnetic, so you can fit it to literally any size, and it just dresses up your watch a little bit. I will just throw the link to that in the description if you guys are interested. Yeah, moving on to my watch. So here is just my home screen, or my lock screen, if you will. I actually created this myself. I did it on my phone and then just set it on my watch. So it just says, work hard, dream big. Again, it's pink, no surprise. So then when you open the watch, this is just what my home screen looks like. And as you can tell, it's color coordinated, or as color coordinated as I could get it. We're just gonna go around the board and talk about what we have. Most of the apps are ones that already came with your watch, but we'll still throw those in there. So we've got Voice Memo and Uber. We have the stocks, which I don't have any stocks to look at, but you know, that's besides the point. We have settings, of course, this little camera one, which goes into my first Apple Watch hack. So this little camera icon actually serves as like a remote to take pictures with your phone. So when you open it, it connects to your phone, and from there you can see what your camera is also seeing. So you can either click on the circle and take a photo, or you can set the timer to 3 seconds and take it from there. This is a big game changer if you're taking like a group photo and you don't have anyone to take it, or I mean, if you want to have a little mini photo shoot by yourself, this is really helpful as well. And I don't think a lot of people realize that this is on their Apple Watch, but I'm telling you, big game changer. Moving on, we've got calculator. And then this yellow icon right here is my second Apple Watch hack, and that is that you can actually use your watch as a walkie-talkie. I actually bought walkie-talkies on the ship with my roommate. They didn't work very well, but you know, the excitement was there. So when I found out about this hack, I was so excited. So basically, you just add friends, and they are people that you have in your contacts. You just talk into your watch just like this, and it gets to their watch. Of course, they have to have an Apple Watch as well. Yeah, this is a really cool thing that I discovered. We've got world clock, the alarm, we've got books, stopwatch, timer, and Babbel. Babbel is one of the apps I use to learn Spanish. We have wallet, which I utilize a ton when I'm paying for something, because my debit and my credit card are actually linked to it, so I can just scan my watch. It's so nice. And also with everything going on, you don't really want to touch a ton of things, so this is hands-free. It's amazing. We've got the clock, we've got music, news, Capital One. So this is linked to my credit card, so whenever I make a purchase with my credit card, I will get a notification through this little app, which is super helpful, so that I know if I was to get hacked, it would come up right away in my watch. Then we have just like the iPhone playing. It'll just tell you what song is currently playing. Now we've got reminders. If you want to set some reminders on your phone, it'll sync to your watch and you can just look down at your wrist, which is super helpful. Below that is just your photos, the Apple Radio, which I don't listen to, Facebook Messenger. I use Facebook Messenger actually a ton now that all my ship friends are from different countries. It's the easiest way for us to communicate. Whenever I get a new message from somebody, it just pops up on my watch like a normal text. Again, clock. Then we've got Google Maps, so anytime I put the GPS on my phone when I'm driving, it also syncs to my watch, which is super helpful so that I don't have to, you know, try to look down because that's not safe. When my hands are on the wheel, I just look at my watch and it'll show me my directions, which is stunning. This one is like Apple Home, but I don't have an Apple Home system, so I never touch that. Then we've got heart rate, so you can actually check your current heart rate. This is great for, you know, exercising and workouts, but also just for day to day to check on how your heart is doing. Then we have Yelp. I get some recommendations and other miscellaneous notifications from that. Starbucks, of course, coming in clutch, very essential. Citizens Bank, that's my bank. Then we have the activity app, which will show you your stand hours, your move minutes, and your exercise minutes. This comes with every watch, but it's really great for keeping track of how active you're staying. We have MyFitnessPal. I use that to sometimes log my meals. The Apple Store, podcasts. If you listen to podcasts, this is great. I don't. Then we got weather, Shazam, my breathe app. It reminds me when I need to breathe. I can always tell when I'm stressed out. Then I have my countdown app if I have, you know, a vacay or something exciting I'm counting down to. City Mapper, that is a great tool for big cities. Then of course, messages and your phone. Then you've got find people. So if you have friends on like Find My Friends, it's just the same thing. I don't know why it's not popping up on my screen, but I do have an app that reminds me to drink water because I'm not the best at it. So you can actually set a timer for how often you want it to remind you. I set mine to an hour. So every hour it tells me to drink water. To me, it's very helpful and it has been very effective. And then the last app is the workout app, which I use every single day to track my workouts. And they have a ton of different types of workouts, which is really cool. And it is pretty accurate because it does have a heart rate monitor in the watch. Now moving on to the watch hacks. We already talked about two. First, the walkie-talkie, and then taking a picture on your phone with your watch. But the next one that I use a ton is to find your iPhone, because I'm that person that never has their sound on. Like, literally, my sound is never on my phone. And before I had an Apple Watch, this was quite problematic when I lost it or misplaced it somewhere in the house, because you can't call it because it won't make a noise. So even if you have your sound off of your phone, you can actually ping it from your watch. So you just slide up from the home screen and you press the little vibrate phone button, and it does that, even if your sound is off. I use that all the time because I'm constantly like putting my phone in a random place in my house and then forgetting where it is. If you're like me and you don't like clutter, there is a way to clear all of your notifications at once. So what you want to do is just slide down to your notifications and press it down really hard, and then it'll say clear all. You just press that and then all your notifications are wiped. It's great. It's so much easier than doing it manually each one. Another little hack that I find really helpful is that you can use your watch to unlock your MacBook if you have a Mac. That way you don't have to type in the password every single time. And to do that, you're gonna have to go onto your MacBook and you just go to settings, security and privacy, then to general, and then you just have to tick the box that says allow Apple Watch to unlock your Mac, and then you're set. So anytime you're by your Mac and it's locked, it'll just automatically unlock with your watch on your wrist. And the final little hack I have for you guys is that you can waterlock your watch, which I'm not sure if a lot of people know, but your Apple Watch is waterproof. I swim with mine. You can go, I want to say, up to 6 feet deep with it on. To waterlock your watch, swipe up from the home screen and then you just click on the little teardrop symbol. It'll waterlock your watch. To unlock it, you just want to turn the digital crown and it ejects all the water that's in it. So, like so. There you have it. So if there is any water inside of the little holes, it'll just spit it out. But that is everything for my Apple Watch. I hope you guys enjoyed. Also, if you guys have any other Apple Watch hacks, comment them down below because I'm always interested to find more. But yeah, that wraps everything up. I love you guys so much. Thank you for watching. Once again, I will be doing a giveaway when I reach 10,000 subscribers, so make sure to subscribe if you're not already. But otherwise, I will just see you in my next video. Bye, guys.